fly, envious time, till thou run out thy race. Call on the lazy-leaded stepping hours, whose speed is but the heavy plummet's pace, and glut thyself with what thy womb devours, which is no more than what is false and vain and merely mortal dross. So little is our loss, so little is thy gain. For when as each thing bad thou hast entombed, and last of all thy greedy self consumed, then long eternity shall greet our bliss with an individual kiss. And joy shall overtake us as a flood, when everything that is sincerely good and perfectly divine, with truth and peace and love, shall ever shine about the supreme throne of him whose happy making sight alone, when once our heavenly guided soul shall climb. Then all this earthly grossness quit, attired with stars, we shall forever sit, triumphing over death and chance and thee, O time.
Fucking intro. Probably one of my all-time favorite game intros. Well, anyway, where was I? After I could not horribly ever possibly follow up with that amazing intro. Oh yeah, I'm 1F Jeff, and, hello. I'll be doing a let's play of this here Silent Hunter's shoot-em-up game. It's like Pong, but with submarines! It's a very realistic submarine simulator, and I love it to death. It's my favorite one of the, well, the entire genre. This will be an unmodified playthrough, completely vanilla 1.3 patch. I know some of you will think that's crazy, but I think most of the overhaul mods are non-substantive. I think, like, if you're playing Silent Hunter 3, yeah, get Ghost Wolves or something like that. But for Silent Hunter 4, they're all mostly optional, you know, conning tower emblems and weird things like that. But I'm not saying they're worthless, but if you want to check out, I think the guys over at Lords of the Greenleaf, Lab and Mr. Cucumber did a playthrough of Silent Hunter 4 with the Trigomaru overhaul, and maybe some other mods too. So if you want to check out a modded playthrough, check that one out. But if you want to check out a vanilla playthrough with all the bullshit that they probably removed, check this one out. So, join me or don't. I don't care. Okay, I do care. Please join me. Let's go. Starting a career. We'll not be John Doe, because we are not John Doe. I'm going to be I can't put Captain, like, because then it will call me Captain. But, wait, no. You know, I mean, if I was in the military and I became a Major, they'd call me Major, so I'll be Captain Private Major. That doesn't fit. I guess I'll just be Captain Private. We'll be starting in 1941, because I don't want, you know, we need to start at the beginning. I don't want you guys to see any spoilers. And you'll know what happened in World War II. So we can start at Pearl Harbor or in the Asiatic Fleet, which is in Malaysia stuff. And they have horrible submarines there. So basically, this is easy mode, this is hard mode. You'll start out in the shit, and Pearl Harbor, you'll start out with a very decent sub, and I'll start out with 2000 Renown, right in the middle of the road. This difficulty setting doesn't matter. I'll customize the setting once I get into the game. But if you start in Pearl Harbor, you usually get a couple fluffer missions in the beginning where you just kind of piddle around in the Pacific and take a tour of the islands and see what's out there. Whereas if you start out in the Asiatic Fleet, they'll start you in between two Japanese battleships. So, let's go! Lieutenant Commander Captain Private! Apparently my first name is Comma. My rank is Lieutenant Commander Captain Private. Lieutenant Commander Captain Private, comma. You've been approved for the command of the USS Gudgeon, a Gar-class submarine assigned to Pearl Harbor. Report to duty at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, no later than December 9th, 1941. So let's roll. I'll get there December 10th, 3 o'clock in the morning, smelling of beer and hookers.
General, as you already know, we are at war. I quote the President of the United States. Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The attack has effectively eliminated our entire battleship force for the time being. As a consolation, it has failed to catch any of our aircraft carriers in port, while the submarines and fuel reserves have escaped unharmed. During the past years, the Japanese military was engaged in a seemingly endless war against China, badly needing oil and other raw materials. Since we halted the trade with Japan, they schemed to seize the oil and mineral-rich East Indies and Southeast Asia. A Japanese attack into the Indies, Malaya, and the Philippines was expected, and plans prepared for it. But obviously, we have not prepared enough for an attack of this magnitude. The attack against Malaya has materialized yesterday, and last night the Japanese forces also attacked Hong Kong, Guam, the Philippines, and Wake Island. This morning, the Japanese continued with an attack on Midway. The Japanese offensive is extending throughout the Pacific, with the submarine force left mostly to itself. We need to act accordingly. For the time being, we will conduct operations as follows. Boats based in Pearl Harbor will patrol in Japanese home waters and also reconnoiter the Marshall Islands, as it's presumed that Japanese forces are massing in that archipelago for a second attack on our bases. Manila-based boats will deploy to guard the vital island of Luzon against approach by enemy forces. Individual patrol orders will be received from your commander.
I'm sorry, what? I wasn't paying attention. You want me to punch Bruce Lee or something like that? I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, here we are. Here's our office, equipped with coffee and a phone and a little baby submarine. It's a dowel ball. I'd take it in the bathtub with me. There's our hat, and there's our lady friend or something. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is go and customize the difficulty settings. Gameplay. So I will be having map updates. I will have no external camera. I'm going to have an external camera. I don't want event view. Realistic reload times, possible dud torpedoes, realistic sensors. No. I will have no stabilized view. So that puts us at 74%. We've got realistic batteries, compressed air, oxygen, fuel, repair time. We have a manual... this is the big one, manual targeting system. That's worth a lot of points. And I've taken a little time to practice, and I'm functional at it. These two are a big deal, obviously, because they let you know what the fuck's going on. But I can't play without them, so there's no point. I tried. I'm stupid. And we'll be using Imperial because I'm a gall-dern American Yank. So deal with it. Alright, I'm positive, thank you. Okay. So I turned up the video brightness, and I think I got the sound levels right. So, that said, let's go ahead and take a look at our submarine. This is the USS Gudgeon, it's a Gar class, and we're going to be changing some of this equipment out. First, we're going to put surface radar on, so we don't get our asses snuck up on by airplanes. I will change out the 20mm anti-aircraft gun for twin 20mm, because two is always better. And we have three 50 caliber deck guns with a stern mounting. I don't know, it's not, we don't actually have three, we have one. I don't know what that means, but whatever. I'll be upgrading it to a bow-mounted gun, because I like having my gun in the front. And we start out with Mark 14 torpedoes, our only alternative at the moment, Mark 10s, and those are horrifying, so don't go with those. One thing I like to do is usually start with a couple of guys that are really good with guns, and I like to stick a couple of those on my... oh, wow, we didn't. We can't promote anybody yet or give out any medals or anything, so I'm going to try to find a better gunner because I want to be able to hire a good gunner for my AA gun. There we go. See this guy here. It costs 900 renown, but he is a good gunner. So you, sir, you're not even a gunner at all. What the hell? whatever. Gunman, Ray Price, you will be our first acquisition. You will be in charge of our anti-aircraft guns. May seem like sort of a waste, but, you know, whatever. And I'll put that guy there, and what do we got here? That guy's a leader. There, that our four-gun, pretty well commanded. Forward torpedo room, more important. What did I just do? Not sure what just happened there, but yes, our forward torpedo gun is more important than our aft torpedo room. Gun room! So we will do that. That leaves us with no renown, but a submarine kitted out the way I like it. We'll assign a damage control team when we need one. And I think that's everything we need to get our asses in gear. This will come later. This is the top skipper's ace board, and RNG willing will end up on it. So yeah, I'm going to do a quick sound check, and then we're off. He sounds okay to me, so let's go. United States Navy, Commander Submarine Specific, Operation Order, December 9th, 1941, to Lieutenant Commander Captain Private, USS Gudgeon. Depart on December 10th, so tomorrow we're leaving. Deploy to Honshu and engage enemy merchant shipping. Objective? Deploy to Honshu. So basically, they're saying, we're all the way over here in Pearl Harbor where it's safe. Why don't you go fucking punch some Japanese people right in the face on their home turf? Thanks, guys. Really appreciate it. Chief of Stash, Lucifer. Chief of Stash? You must have an amazing mustache. Move over, Mario. Alright, so we're going to be starting outside the harbor. We could start inside, but it just adds to the amount of things I have to do. So, easy mode. And I will not be having loading screens on this. As much as I like loading screens better than elevators, say, for example. In this one, when you're recording them, it makes you crash. So, I can't. Anyway, love and huggles. I'll be back soon. Alright, so, this is the command room of the USS Gudgeon, where Lieutenant Commander Captain Private will be, probably dying. Next to creepy helmsman guy who will stare at my ass for the entirety of this campaign. He's got a map, but he won't be staring at that. Look at that creepy motherfucker. Alright, all these guys have knobs and switches to turn when I tell them to. Up here is the conning tower, which we're in right now, which has all sorts of flashing doohickeys. I don't know what they do. I know what this is, though. I'm pretty sure this is our sonar. I don't know, it just said right there. Radar. This is our radar. This is our sonar, right here. Oh my god, the music stopped. Send bearing to TDC. Ping. Ping. Meow. I don't know what this does. This guy's taking care of it, though. And this guy does... No, that's sonar, too. What's this guy do? Radar? Something over here is radar. There's a red one, too, somewhere. That might be the... No, we don't have one for those yet. We don't have a surface radar. Or, a naval radar. Anyway, let's head out into the wild blue yonder. Here we are. Outside of Pearl Harbor on our ship. And as you can see, I requested that they add this little rod here so that my submarine would be a unicorn. This is... I don't know what this guy's name is, but here he is. And he has no eyeballs. Look at that! That's fucking creepy! Where the fuck are your eyebrows? Or eyeballs? That's disgusting. He's got no... They're just empty sockets. That's really weird. Do you have eyes? No, I can't see when I'm zoomed in. Anyway, so I'll go ahead and give the orders from here to make it official. Yes, I'm not going to go flank speed. We're going to go standard speed for fuel preservation, because we haven't got a lot of it. The range on this class of submarine, I think, is 11,000 miles, and we're going to be traveling about 4,000 just to get to our objective. Most of the game will take place in the map room, which is here, where we are staring at a map. We're here in Pearl Harbor. The enemy, the other man, is all the way over here, in Japan. There's our objective, right off the coast of Kyushu, where unfortunately they have a great deal of naval and air power. Everywhere in this game you see, you can go. If I wanted to sail to Abu Dhabi, and I had enough gas to do it, I could. I don't know why, but that's awesome. So, yep, what we're going to do here is plot a course for our objective. Actually, we're going to plot a course for a stepping off point. We're going to sail to Midway and refuel and refit, because we won't have enough gas, frankly, to make it if we don't. So we'll dodge these little... And they're not, most of them aren't little islands, but just to be sure, because some of them have little spits of land sticking out, I don't want to ground my... That'd be really embarrassing. So what happened on the mission? Well, I ran into some dirt. Oh, that's cool. And off we go. Come on, buddy. Refit. Refit complete. Alright, fuel 100%. Now let's GTFO from here. And go punch some Japanese people in the face. What do we got there? Oh, those are the stationary ships. Is it... Dang it, I keep hitting the wrong key. Yeah, they're somewhere. Whatever. So, plot a new course to our objective, which is here. It's always good to put a couple of extra checkpoints in the way in case you need to modify things later on. A straight line is usually not a good idea. It also makes you extremely predictable. It's a good thing they didn't ask me to patrol in here, because that is Clusterfuckerton. We may get new objectives when we reach our little marker there, but yet to be seen. So, I'm not 100% sure if there are things in this that I should off-screen or not. It seems reasonable that I would off-screen something like a really, really boring long journey. But once I'm not in range of Midway anymore, things will speed up real quick and I'll just be there. What? A merchant. A merchant emergency. I wasn't paying attention. I was just waiting. Alright, here we have a sound contact. So this is where things get fun for me. Oh my god, why are we at... Why is our fuel so low? I must have been doing something wrong. Oh, I should have been going at 2/3 instead of standard. Damn it. Oh my god, that sucks. Alright, anyway, we'll deal with that. Hopefully we can refit at Manila. So, what I've done here is I've marked its location right now. And as you can see, it's moving, and it looks like it's moving directly into my current course, which is just awesome. Because where we are, it's probable that this is Japanese. Whoa. Uh-oh. Somebody crashed their boat into the dock here at Midway. Hopefully it wasn't an important boat. Good job, jackass. Alright, so... I just put us to periscope depth. I didn't really mean to do that, because there's no way he can see us. We're pretty far away. Yeah, we're 8 nautical miles away at night. 5 nautical miles away is about when the visual range kicks in during the day, so it's a bit ridiculous. I'm going to tell my guys to surface the boat, and we'll continue carrying on at a slow speed. But what I can do is mark his course again, and now we can extrapolate his trajectory and plan and intercept. Now, there's all sorts of saucy tools you can use to make this more interesting. You can be all like, oh my god, it's a circle and then a thing, but, and then you can be like, magnifying glass and then there's this other thing and, you know, like, triangle, circle, laser beams. I don't know what the fuck those things do, or how to use them to my advantage. I may use them. I remember I used some before, but mostly what I'll be using in this will be the straight... Oops, I just erased my favorite line. The ruler and the pencil. Because that's how I get shit done. And I won't be using that either. Okay, so let's lay down our course again of our merchant ship here. Because we're going to sink him. Whether he likes it or not. Alright, so he's going to travel along this line here and we're going to intercept him. Hopefully we can get to this point before he does. So I'm going to leave my course right now and turn a little bit to the left so I can meet him right about here. What I want to do is mark out a nautical mile for me to see so I'll know when I'm in range. Because you want to be somewhere right about here before you fire a torpedo. Alright, I've got myself turned a little bit too far, actually. There we go. We're headed towards our intercept course. You can see on the sonar he's heading up here. Right now, I I have a choice. I should probably submerge and then put it in flank speed and try to meet him underwater, because I don't want him to see me. I need to be here before he sees me, and I need to be underwater and preferably standing still. So hopefully he won't see me. I don't know why it just went to 20 feet again. Oh, I know what it is. Fucking huge-ass waves. This is going to make it really difficult. Yeah, there's 20-foot waves. That's what it means when it says depth 20 feet. fortunately, the weather... Oh, shit. We're in visual range. So, that means we've already screwed up. But that's okay. Let's take a look and see if he has any guns on his boat. Where are you? He's out there somewhere. Anybody got a bearing on this guy? Give me a bearing. What's his bearing? Does the targeting data computer have his bearing? No. Oh, I'm all the way over here. Yeah, I'm kind of surprised that he saw me. He may not have seen me. I'm gonna hope that he didn't see me. Go to periscope depth, and my god, that seems so loud to me. Maybe it's just my volume on my headset or something like that. Anyway, I'm gonna continue on. It doesn't look like he saw me, because he hasn't been weaving back and forth and in and out and stuff. So, let's see here. He's gonna be... Alright, we should be good to slow down here. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in reverse a little bit, and then we're gonna stop it. So I think, let me check and see if he's still on a standard course. Easy enough for me to do. Put down markers where I see him. We can tell if he's weaving. I don't think he's weaving. I don't think he knows where I am. Now if he doesn't have guns, some of the ships have guns, some of them don't. If he doesn't have guns, then there's no point shooting torpedoes at him. I'll just surface and then we'll shoot him with our deck gun. That's what it's there for. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and pop open my attack periscope and open up tubes 1 and 2, and we'll get up our targeting stuff. So this is our targeting input terminal panel dealio, and we need to find ourselves our target. There he is. He does not have any guns. I just want to make sure. I'm going to identify him. Mostly this is for practice. Oops. I need to be able to do this on the fly and quickly. Oh my god, look at these waves. That is insane. Where'd he go? I hope he doesn't get sunk naturally. I want the credit for it. Alright, so what I'm looking for is things like the towers here, and then mostly the engine stack and the conning tower up on the top. So I know that it's a mid tower, it's a small ship, probably a split tanker, a very small one. This looks kind of like it. Coastal composite freighter, maybe. I'd have to be able to see it again. No, that's definitely not it. It doesn't have any of this stuff going on in the back. No. That could be it, but that's medium, so it's not. Medium old split freighter, maybe. No, that's too big. This guy can't be more than something like this. Small modern composite. That's it. You can see the stack right there. There's the tower. There's the stack. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's not. I don't know. I can't tell. No, that's probably not it. That kind of looks like it. All these fucking things look like it. It's one of these fucking things. I'll know when I sink the son of a bitch. I'm gonna guess it's a small old split freighter. So I'll put that in, although we're not gonna be shooting it with our targeting data computer. Just for an example though, what we would do, I don't know what this does necessarily, position keeper, it just keeps an eye on what I've got for my position on it. You can guesstimate the range by using this tool here to line it up to the stacks, input that to the targeting data computer, estimate the position, and then have your crew estimate the speed, or you can look at your book and guesstimate the speed. It's probably going about 6. I wasn't even looking at it, so they can't. You would do that, and then you would look at your attack computer and see what the trajectory was. It's pretty close, even though I've just been flubbing around with it. But none of that stuff matters, because what we're going to do now is call our crew to battle stations, and we're going to surface the boat. We're going to go all left and 2/3 speed. Head slow. Make it so, bro. Mm-hmm. I'm just glad you have eyeballs, dude. So here we are, emerging from the depths. Oh, that's got to be a sucker sight for them. What is that? Is that the Loch Ness Monster? You wish, bro. You wish. It's a fucking submarine, and it's got a really, really, really big gun on the front of it. These waves suck. It's going to be a real pain in the ass to target in this thing, but we'll get it done. Howdy! Alright, so man the deck gun. We're going to be aiming for the waterline, and if my guys suck at it, I'll take over, but I'm going to try to have them go ahead and shoot. So, shoot. Don't fire at Will, fire at those guys. Shoot them. Cannot man the deck gun, the seas are too rough. Maybe we will have to use a torpedo. Fuck. And they know when we're here. Oh, there we go. He got off a shot. I hope that was us shooting and not him. Yeah. What the hell? Crap. Great, when there's no wave, I can't get on the deck gun, and when there is a wave, I can. What? Right.
Yes, sir. Water.
Right, okay. Here we go. No, let me shoot again. I want to shoot. I'm underwater, but I'm going to shoot anyway. There we go. Oh, so he's got an anti-aircraft gun. Ah, I got him. I'll just shoot the son of a bitch. I don't care. Yeah, they've got little tiny guns. Nothing worth worrying about. I don't know what they're shooting him at, but we're down here, guys. You are a horrible shot, bro. What's your name, dude? What is your name? Oh, they're shooting at me with their anti-aircraft guns now. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and put it in... I don't need an emergency back. But we want to get a little further out of range, because those things have just horrible range. Our deck gun can far outrange them. What are you shooting at? They're right there. That seems weird to me, at first, to be shooting at the water, but you really do want to shoot for the water line, because that's what you're gonna get to sink them. I can't even see you. There we go. I saw a flash. I know I hit him. He's probably not too happy about it either. What the hell are you looking at? He's over here. Why is everybody so interested in what's going on over there? Oh, you barely hit him. But hey, a hit's a hit.
Yes, sir.
So we'll stop a little bit and just kind of hang out and let our deck gunner blow this guy up. Yeah, I can see their little tiny guns right now. Hey, you got 2 hits. Good job, bro. They're not on fire yet, so nothing to celebrate so far. I prefer this. Oh my god. What the fuck? Boom. It's already listing a little to the left. I'm gonna speed up time a little bit. Come on. There we go. Yeah, she's toast. She won't be around much longer, if you know what I mean. If you get my drift, if you follow my idea, I missed. I think she's actually already sinking. Yeah, definitely sinking, just not completely sunk yet. Man, these seas are really fucking rough. Yep, it's just a matter of time for her. In fact, it's not even really worth wasting any more bullets.
Yes, sir.
If she needs more shots, I'll put her down myself. In the meantime, we're just going to watch her sink.
Yes, holding fire.
Thank you. Good night, little fella. Pretty sure that's an old split. Down you go. Come on. There you go. You're on fire now. Things are not looking good for you. I'll turn a little to the right so we don't lose it. We'll be notified when when it's confirmed as a sunk ship. You don't want to lose sight of it, because you can lose confirmed sinks. You're pretty well underwater, bro. Just give it up. You're not going to bail that out. Even if your ship wasn't fucking broken, the ocean might sink you. But trust me, your ship's broke. It's totally broke. These are some really, really, really rough seas. Wow. Beautiful fucking game, though. Alright, where's our prey? Here you are. Yeah, you've got issues. Oh, and you're exploding. Ooh, that looked like it hurt. Yeah, I don't think you're gonna make it, dude. Come on, bro, just give it up. You got holes all in you. Look at holes everywhere. Yeah, this would have been an ideal situation. Are your engines spinning? No, he's dead in the water. Nope, he's got one propeller almost spinning. Why are you trying? Just sink. Come on. Go down. Enemy unit destroyed. Flooding had overtaken the ship. So there we go. The cargo pops off. The enemy crew disengages and gets out of the boat. There they go. They're off in their little raft. And we have our first victory. The USS Gudgeon strikes first blood. Oh yeah. Way to go, dude. You didn't miss too many shots. Not too shabby. Alright, so we predicted their course, we intercepted them, and then we played around with the targeting data computer. I probably did some stuff wrong, but I was just messing around with it. So we're going to secure from battle stations. We don't need them to be on anymore. We're on a pleasure cruise at the moment. Return to our course, and head on out. I really hope Manila's still there, because the way I screwed off half of our fuel trying to get here. Yeah, that's not good. Alright, so, back on course. Hopefully this, situation with the weather will not last, because if it does, I may have to abort the mission. Alright, so we're almost at our objective. Okay, here we are. We've received a new command. We are to engage enemy merchant shipping in the area around Honshu. Which is, you know, like, where the fuck is Honshu? I see Kyushu and Shikoku and, Honshu. Pretty much everywhere along the coast of Japan. So that's fun, if you like dying. I don't. But, orders are orders. So, off we go. Oh my god, that's a bad patrol idea. You know, I'm real tempted to just go... Oh no, Manila's gone. Fuck. It's not a subtender anymore. When did I miss that? Manila under constant air attack. Maybe they just bombed it out of existence. I had a feeling that would happen. Okay, so from where we are right now, the nearest base is, let's see, 27,000, 2,700, 3,200, 4,400, 38. So yeah, it looks like, let's see if I can pronounce this right. Why is everything always covering up? I can't tell if that's a J or an I. I'll say it's Surabaya. It is 2,600 miles away from here. Not counting all these fucking islands. So... From Midway, it was about 3,000. So we should be able to make it. But just. I'm considering running over there after not engaging anything here. Because it'll be a fucking hot run either way. In fact, I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go back to my patrol after we've refitted, because I screwed up with the fuel. I don't want to get stuck here and not be able to make it back, so we'll probably go through the South China Sea, because that'll be dangerous, and danger is what they sent me here for. head down through Luzon, it would be so easy to just crash here in Manila and refuel, but no, they had to fucking take it from us, didn't they? Assholes. Alright. Yeah, this is gonna be a rough one. Through the Karamata Strait to get to Surabaya in Java. So, looks like it's about 3,000 nautical miles. Oh boy. Fun times, everybody. It's gonna take 60 hours to get just this far. So this will take days and days and days. This could take weeks for us just to get refueled because of this fucking sea that we're in. We just got a medium warship closing near us. A medium warship? That's interesting. That's so interesting that I'm not gonna turn tail and run immediately. I wanna find out where he's headed. Well, also, I noticed that for some reason if I record for a long time in this game, the frames drop to 15 frames per second, unless I stop and restart, so I may do that occasionally. Don't worry, I'll probably let you know. Like now! Ta-da! Okay. Whew. I'm actually gonna slow down a bit. Because, he looks like he's coming. Where'd my pencil go? Seriously, where the fuck is my pencil? Okay, my pencil disappeared. I don't like that. I cannot live without my pencil. It's called a marker, but it is a pencil. Obviously, it makes marks, but it's still a pencil. So the one thing you really gotta worry about is that these warships have front-facing radar. Usually. Sonar, that is. So it's tough to get within striking distance of them without them knowing exactly where you are. But, seeing as we are, holy shit, put it in reverse. You can also go really deep, like below the thermal layer. Whoa, I never said anything about that. Alright, let's get back on course. That looks about right. What are we looking at now? Let's find out a good range here. Okay, so we're going to stop here. I'm actually going to continue to put it in reverse a little bit. I'll crank it left some more, because we're going to try to come up behind him. Get out of his range. No, left more. There. Alright, now we're going to go really, really, really deep. The only thing that's helping me here is that he's going so slow. It seems like he's going faster, though. It's just time compression. So I'm going to have my sonar man send this stuff to the targeting data computer. If I can remember, yeah. And speed and range, right? No, bearing and range. What about speed, bro? So, we're going to go to periscope depth. It looks like we were already at periscope depth, which is concerning. I don't know how much CO2 we have here. Alright, so our compressed air level... doing good, 100 out of 100. Engine, not so hot. But there's no way in fucking hell I'm surfacing right now, because we're about a 1 mile away from a medium-speed warship, which could be, frankly, anything. Could be a destroyer, could be a heavy cruiser. Usually heavy cruisers, and frigates don't travel alone. Destroyers will, though. So, like I said, I'm hoping he will pass right by us along this course and not ping us with his radar, which is probably, the range of it is probably, that's not the right tool, this one. It's probably something like that. So, saying he gets here, again, it'll be like that, and we should be able to sneak in behind it. I'm guesstimating here. You think he would have got us by now. So, what we're going to do is have our crew get to the battle stations and rig for silent running. So when you're around warships with sonar, you have to, which means you can't go above 1/3 speed. So we're going to try to very slowly creep up on him here. Now, assuming he continues on his course, that is where our cutoff will be for firing, theoretically, if he doesn't notice. So theoretically, we might be able to hit him now, because we're within a nautical mile. Or we should be. Actually, going to crank it up to two-thirds here. Come on, get me closer. Okay, so I'm going to try to calculate a solution. So we're going to raise the periscope, put ourselves into stop. Where you at, buddy? Where you at? There we are. It is a destroyer. It is a small, teeny, tiny one. Hopefully it didn't see me. And the ticking is still there. That's fantastic. Okay. So we're going to get out of we're going to get out of merchants. Oh my god, these waves are killing me. It's not a battleship. It's not a Tuma. That's it. It is a small gunboat. There's no way in fucking hell I'm going to torpedo that. You kidding me? 900 tons? No. Periscope, go down. Why is it going medium speed? That's what I want to know. Yeah, we're just going to let him pass on by. Have fun storming the castle. That sounds really loud. I'm going to go ahead and check my audio levels, because that sounded like way loud. I'll surface the boat soon, but for now, we're just going to trundle along. So far, this has been pretty uneventful. Like I said, the first mission is usually uneventful. Usually, it's a lot shorter, though. Son of a bitch! Oh, fucking hell. Oh, no. I know what I did. Periscope damaged. Batteries damaged. Oh, no. Periscope destroyed. Deck gun damaged, sir. Flight gun damaged, sir. Oh, God. We fucked up bad. I left it on battle stations. Son of a bitch. Oh, fuck. Clear from battle stations. Periscope depth. Crash dive. They're going to be coming at us hard. We were going 0 knots. Everybody on the whole ship was sleeping. Because I'm an idiot. Oh my god, we're going to die. Oh my god. Okay. Flank speed. Crank it. No, it's not. Alright. I need as many people as I can. Oh my god, you guys are injured. You're not going to do shit. Okay, you guys. You. Shut the fuck up. Get in there. Do something. We don't need our torpedoes right now. We need our shit repaired. I think there's an easier way to do this. I don't know what it is, but whatever. Get your ass in there and wake the fuck up. Yeah, I know we do. I'm doing the best I can, bro. Oh my god, maintain current orders. Yes. Somebody's got to be awake, right? No, you're sleeping. Your efficiency is 10. Son of a bitch. Somebody repair something. Don't go below 50, because we've got flooding. If we do, we'll never get up. Oh, this is bad. I can't believe I did that. Hey, everybody, stay on position forever. And everybody's in here man-sweating, all naked. Alright, so... Is that a fucking ship? No, that's a plane. Is my periscope up too? No, it's not. Okay, that was our last known contact. Whoa, why are we going down below? Oh boy. Alright, he missed. Fuck you guys. Okay, rudder. I get it, rudder. Come, rudder. Oh my god. Okay, I think he stopped yelling rudder. He said it about 30 more times. I had to stop recording. Okay, so that was a colossal fuck up, but I think we're okay. So, yeah. Don't do that. A cautionary tale by me. How to get bombed by aircraft while sitting still in the water and wasting more of your fuel and requiring... Oh, shit. Son of a... Yeah, we can still get fucking killed here. Control room. Okay, we need to... Control room bulkhead, that's our priority. I gotta surface the ship. We can't maintain. Oh, shit! Okay, he's going away. They're both going away. Come on, just give me enough time to repair our fucking flooding. Periscope repaired. Critical flooding? That doesn't sound good. I'm just gonna offer a guess here. Holy shit. Can we please fucking fix this shit? Please? Now? Like, right now? Who's awake? You're awake. Go replace one of these injured guys. No, you were injured. Replace him. Or is getting all shuffled around now? You're awake. Replace him. Whatever, I need people that are awake to work in damage control for me. Because this is bad. We have critical flooding, and we need our goddamn hydraulic pump to work. Okay, pump's intact. Big one. Now, if we could just get this flooding out of here, that'd be swell. Please? Can we get the flooding before we sink? Son of a bitch! He's coming back. I gotta go to periscope depth. I have to. I won't go any lower, but I gotta go that low. I'm gonna put it at flank speed so we get in quicker. Oh shit! Oh god. We're dead. Current depth, 160 feet, passing thermal layer. Shit! Blow the ballast. We're dead. Here's our current depth. If we don't start rising... Okay, we're barely rising. I told him to periscope, and it ended up sinking us. We may not make it to the surface. Holy shit.
Passing thermal layer.
Okay, we're on the way up. Alright. We blew our ballast, and we are, flank speed. Get us the fuck out of here. I don't care. Just don't let us go. If we had gone any lower, we'd have depressurized and been destroyed. That was close. What the fuck? I am not a very good submarine boat captain. Oops. I'm also not very good at this whole recording thing, because I keep punching my microphone. So, things are going swell for me. How about you? And we're going to surface, and there's probably going to be a bomber airplane right on top of our faces. So that's fun. What do you know? Yep. Yep. Fuck it, engage him. Get your ass on there. Fire. Fire! Whatever range possible. Any range. Long range. Short range. Just shoot the motherfucker. If you don't, we're dead. Hell, we're probably dead anyway. Evasive maneuvers. Just get us the hell out of here. Oh my god. Get on the fucking gun! Where is he? He's out there somewhere. There he is. Get him! Don't hold fire! Fire! Shoot! No! Don't hold fire! Do fire! Oh god. I think he missed us, but still, damn. Firing at will, okay. No, medium range to long range. Target. Closing targets. Sure. Did we just start... Oh my god. Not again. Motherfucker. Blow our ballast, please. Oh god, this is it. It's over. Look how fast we're sinking. We're screwed. We didn't have any ballast to blow. Oh boy. Please fix the main pump right now, everybody. Or we're dead. Alright, I know they're all sleeping, but fuck it, we need them. Wake up. Get your asses doing something. Fix something. Main pump, please. Alright, so for the moment, we're back up in the air. I want to see if we've got any holes blown in this beast. I mean, obviously we do. I just want to know where they are. I don't see any visible holes. Must all be strafing bullet holes. Engage it. And don't sink! Yeah, I don't see any visible holes.
Yes, sir. Firing at long range.
Yes. Do that. Yep. All of that stuff. Do it. Main pump fix now. Looks like it was slightly repaired since last time. Okay, where's he coming from? Right there. Get him, please. I don't see him. We're gonna turn left, though, to give our rear AA gun a better shot at hitting him. Oh no, it's... Oh god! Ow! That's loud. Yeah, get him! Get... Yes! 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 Oh shit. Fuck, 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 fuck! Oh, we're dead! He fucking crashed into us! Oh my god. Yeah, we're fucking dead. That son of a bitch crashed right into us. Oh my god. Yeah, we got flooding everywhere. Holy shit. That son of a bitch. Yeah, it's over. Sorry, everybody. I love you guys. You're my best friends. But we're dead.
Yes, sir. I had blood burn. Yes, sir.
It's been real nice knowing you. Oh, my God. Bro. Go fix something, you stupid bastard. Stop staring at me. Yep, there it is. We're sinking. Well, shit. That was kind of hilarious, I gotta admit. We didn't get to do anything. We sunk one teeny tiny little thing, and we avoided a bunch of crap, and then we got our asses crashed into, but... Oh my god. Okay, well, I couldn't have screwed up much more than that. Yeah. So that was fun. Alright, so practice is over. We're on to the real thing now. Good times, everybody. I needed that, that reminder. And I gotta admit, that was kind of fucking epic. That way to go out. We completed deployed to Honshu. We did not engage or destroy any merchant shipping. We sunk one merchant ship for 3,000 tons, and then we were destroyed and killed. We were posthumously awarded the Submarine Service Medal for extraordinary heroism as commanding officer of the USS Gudgeon during the one war patrol of that vessel. The Navy Board of Decorations and Medals awards the Submarine Service Medal to Lieutenant Commander Captain Private. His inspiring name and aggressiveness are in keeping with the highest traditions of the United... I like that. His aggressiveness. Yes, he obviously was a little too aggressive. So that was fun. Yeah, although the Admiral wrote that he regretted to inform your next of kin of your demise at sea, something makes you suspect that he was actually a bit relieved. Thankfully, and maybe out of respect for someone that ultimately gave their life in the service, your abysmal record was scrubbed before making it to the National Archives. Your family still thinks of you as a hero, at least. Basically, what that says is, you fucking suck, bro! And believe me, I did. So yes, that was our practice one. We'll get on to the real thing, the actual hardcore mode now. Where, death will be, death. That was sort of an intro video, an hour or so long, and then after that we'll get on to the regular serialized content, which I'll begin probably tomorrow or the day after, something like that. I'm gonna be analyzing this to see what people think and what I need to change. So, for the real thing. So join me for that. For now, this has been Uno FAFA, signing out with a hilarious ending. As always, yeah. You can't make that shit up, dude. I shot down a plane and it crashed into my boat. And I had a really good view of it. That's awesome. I can't wait to watch that later. Alright. Goodbye. See you in the next one.